My name is Katrina Leary, and this is my communications presentation. I decided to do my presentation on the KUC dance group. This is the Kuskokwim campus dance group. The Kuskokwim campus is a part of UAF. This is them performing at FNA, which is the Federation of Native Arts, or the Festival of Native Arts, or Fairbanks Native Association Festival. Here they are traditionally dancing. These are the men in the front, the woman in the back, and I had the privilege of interviewing them, and here attached is a clip of them performing. And this is just an audio clip as a visualization. You can hear them. Hard drumming of the drum. As I said before, they are based on the Kuskokwim, also Bethel, Alaska. I actually took all of these pictures. This is the waterfront Bethel in the summertime. This is a significant, I think, a significant part of Bethel, and the tundra is the berries, and the berries that provide the ayuk, which is tundra tea, the tundra cotton, and the endless skyline that the tundra provides, and the sunset of the tundra, which I think is amazing and beautiful. Traditional attire of a dance group is the headdress, traditionally made with fur on the top and the bottom fabric, and is worn with by women. A gusbuk, which is what I'm wearing right now, is what women traditionally wear dancing. And these are beluguks, which are boots made traditionally seal, walrus, sea mammal, but nowadays they make them with calfskin because it's readily available. These are women's dance bands, made by the tuft of a caribou. Around, they can have beaver or wolf or otter, and then the holders are woven grass. The men's dance bands are feathers of a large bird, and they're usually wood rather than grass. Wood and some kind of sinew. So I got to interview the KUC dance group. They have 17 people currently in the dance group, and they're always hoping to expand. KUC is growing larger. They've been off and on dance groups since the 80s or 90s, and this is the biggest the dance group has ever been. The age ranges, I said before, 18 to 24. Ben told me 18 to 30, because they have two house parents or dorm parents who are in the 30s who stay with them, and they also participate in the dance group. As I said before, we're going on an Indigenous Renaissance, which means younger people are standing up and rising up and taking part in traditional knowledge and traditional culture. The two dance leaders, right here, are Chase Alexi from Bethel and Benjamin from Chifornik. And they, too, are the ones that compose most of the songs or get the songs passed down for them. They ask for the permission. They are the group leaders. They conduct dance practices. They set up performances, and they basically take charge. As you can see, here are the women with traditional gear, and here they are practicing, men in the front, girls in the back dancing. This song that they are about to perform, that I actually had the privilege of recording, is a song by Benjamin's grandpa, Paul Adema of Chifornik. He was out on the Kwikset River looking for gold. I'm assuming that this is an older song because they didn't mine in the Kwikset River only in the early 1900s, late 1800s. As you can see, as they're performing, is that they're looking for the gold. They're boating up the river. They're having trouble finding the gold. They have to hike back in the mountains. And there's a huge horizon, and he's looking for the gold. And they start off traditionally with one drummer. They start off very slow, and as they go on, the dance song goes on, they start fast. As a young group, they've had to realize that they need to raise their own money to travel to perform. They have performed at FNA, Fairbanks Native Association Festival. They performed at the Jemai Festival in Bethel, which is a local festival in Bethel, a huge dance festival, traditional, non-traditional, and they hope in the future to perform at more festivals as they keep growing and get their name out. Here is them performing a song. Just the men example. And you, traditionally men are just the drummers, but as we are expanding our renaissance, women have to be more involved. I learned from them that most songs are composed by elders or leaders of other dance groups. And because this dance group is so young and fresh, that most of their songs are actually not theirs, and they have to ask permission from other elders from different villages for permission to perform the songs. Most of their songs are from Trifornik, which is where Benjamin Agemik is from. Most of the songs are from his grandpa, Paul Agemik, who was an elder of Trifornik. Some songs can't be interpreted because in the Yupik language, some words just don't have meanings in the English language. So these songs are so old that they just sometimes can't be interpreted. They're hoping to attend more dance festivals in the future, and they are trying to raise money to do that and get their name out, hopefully travel to the Lower 48, because they're such a young group. They think that they can inspire other young indigenous people. These are the drums made by Benjamin Agemik. His grandpa Paul Agemik made this from Trifornik. It's calf skin, not traditional, because traditional was seal skin, walrus, any other sea mammal. It was handed down. It is actually so old that when they drum it, they have to continuously spray it with water. These drums are made by Benjamin Agemik. These are just canvas and following the traditional style of the wood sticking out and a traditional drum with the wood frame. I just want to say a huge thank you to Benjamin Agemik for one, letting me interview him, and the rest of his dance group, Essie, Molly, June, Moses, Jeffrey, Benjamin, Chase, and Thomas. Thank you.